And one of the things I'm excited about is the fact that it's the first time Junior Team at Jamaica is participating. And I'm also excited for the fact that Scotia is an international sponsor.
Well, you know, as you probably know, we've been in Jamaica for 120 years. So we're as much a bank in Canada as we're a bank in Jamaica. And Junior Achievement, I know you're very involved in it and very proud of it. Same for us. You know, we think it's one of those great worldwide organizations where you take these kids who, without that connection, would be very focused on their own country, wouldn't get the opportunity to learn all these skills. And the connections you were talking earlier about, the connections that your kids in Jamaica are making with all these kids internationally, it's a fantastic thing. Scotiabank, we're very, very proud to be involved.
Yeah, we're excited for a few reasons again. So we have 5 students that came up to Jamaica, from Jamaica to Kingston. And it's, most of them, it's the first time they've ever gotten on a plane. And to know that the reason why they're getting on a plane is because they have won in their school, the company program, Most Valuable Person. And then to experience what other students are doing around the world is just tremendous for them. Just flying, just putting on a seatbelt on the plane was just a new experience.
Sure.
And then also in Jamaica, we have some commitment from Scotia there. We had our first invitational board meeting and had Scotia Jamaica was there. And we also have some projects that we're looking at. We're looking at adopting 15 company programs next year in Jamaica. So we have 5 schools this year. Just with Scotia alone, we're going to triple that. So we're very excited about the ongoing commitment.
Well, you know, these countries, like Jamaica, as they evolve, the leadership is so, so important. And leadership starts very, very young. Take these kids and expose them to other ideas, people, their cultures, other languages, and have them take that as a kernel, as a seed that's going to develop and grow through the core of their life. That then when they're leaders, when they're 20, 30, 40 years old, they can think back to starting from that. And I think it's a marvelous experience. Because it's a world where so fast. The information is going so quickly that for kids to be able to grasp that out of the world, make those connections that are going to stand them in such valuable stead, that I know you're excited to be part of it.
Seeing Junior Achievement in a different light.
Yeah.
For 13 years as a volunteer in Connecticut, and love the experience.
Yeah.
And that's why I just said, well, we'd love to see this in Jamaica. And for the past year, just to see the excitement in the children's lives, like, just in school, it's out of school that we're trying to reach. And some haven't left their community, much less their parish and then their country. And so to be able to interact and learn and have volunteers become role models to inspire them, it's something that they're not used to. And they're not used to seeing it day to day on the streets. And now they're getting that and getting so much from it. And I know it will benefit their country, their community, Jamaica, and the world.
Well, I know as a bank, one of the important things about being a bank and being a worldwide bank is that you take that knowledge, you take the different ways of doing things around the world, and you're open to it. And the fact that you have this knowledge, this culture, different ways of doing things from around the world, it makes you a better organization and it makes you a better person. And so for these kids, I really think it's just an invaluable thing to be part of something like this where they learn about so many other people and so many other ways of doing things. And, you know, as I said, I think that openness will stay with them forever. And it's a great thing.